Mr. Tarrou.
Okay, we're going to start taking a look at solving equations with logarithms. This will probably be a two-part video since I have a lot of examples I'd like to go over with you. Okay, first example. We're going to have 5 to the x minus 2 divided by 6 equals the square root of 5. Now, this particular equation is not going to require logarithms to solve it. Well, first of all, logarithms at this level of mathematics is most commonly used for solving equations where the variable is in the exponent. Think of your compound interest formulas like continuous compound interest. A equals principal times e to the rt power. Well, a lot of times you could be solving equations like how long does it take for your money to double at a certain interest rate? Well, if that variable is in the exponent, you're going to need logarithms to help you solve it, to move that variable down out of the exponent into the main line of the question. So we're not going to do any application problems today. It's all algebra. However, sometimes you can get an equation. If you can get both bases to match on the left and right hand side, then you can just set the equation, the exponents equal to each other and will not need logarithms. So in this particular example, a square root power can be rewritten as in a fractional exponent form as 1/2. So this is going to be 5 to the x minus 2 over 6 power, quite a complicated exponent there, equals 5 to the 1/2 power. Well, now that I have matching bases on each side of the equation, and I try to pick a relatively complicated one here, or come up with a complicated one, so that maybe the simpler ones in the beginning of your homework assignment just look that much easier. Once your common bases are the same, or you get those same bases, you set the exponents equal to each other, and then solve. And a lot of those problems will not require you to do cross multiplication, but just the point of, if you get like bases, you have to have your exponents be equal to each other. So when I cross multiply, I'm going to get 2 times x minus 2 equals 6. Distribute the 2 through, and we get 2x minus 4 equals 6. Bring the 4 over to the other side of the equation by doing the opposite. So I'm going to add both sides by 4 and get 2x equals 10, and then divide everything by 2, and x equals 5. So if I plugged 5 into here, I should get the equivalent of the square root of 5. So let's see, 5 minus 2 is 3. 3 divided by 6 reduces to 1/2, and yes, a power of 1/2 is equivalent to the notation of the square root of 5. Good. So we got our solution, x equals 5. Now another equation that does not, will require the use of logarithms is this one. E is base 2.718. It's like pi, it runs on forever. So E is 2.718. So this base is 2.7 Over here you have a base of 7. So we are not going to get both sides of this equation to have the same base. So we'll require logarithms. Now which log do you choose? If you use regular log, which is perfectly fine, it will not cancel with the base of e, and that will cause you to have to take a few extra steps, such as pulling this x out front using the power property, and then now that your x is down in the main line of the problem, dividing everything by the log of e. But I would not choose to do the problem this way because I've just written quite a few steps. If, instead of using my common log, I use natural log, well, natural log is log base e. And if you're logging a number and the number that you're logging has the same base of your log itself, those are inverse functions. They'll cancel out and undo each other, and this just becomes x equals the natural log of 7, and whatever decimal comes out of your calculator is the answer. Let's see. Yeah, I just have that written as natural log of 7. I was going to say something in the middle there, and I lost track of what I was going to say. Oh, that the log function and the exponent, those are inverse functions of each other. That's why this is canceling out. If you log 100, you get 2, and the reason why is because 10 squared is 100. Did you catch what I just said there? The log base 10 of 100 gives you, that math function gives you the answer of 2. The log function gave us 2. If I wanted to undo that log function and get back to the original 100, 10 squared is 100. So that common log and that common base on the exponent, those are inverse functions and thus they cancel out. So if the base of your log is the same as the base of what you're logging, those functions will cancel out, and the variable in the exponent may occasionally just drop down in the main line of the problem, and all of a sudden you've saved quite a few steps. So my next example that I want to take a look at is got a base of 10. So 10 to the x equals 41. Now for this one, my notation, I would want to use common log because we have a base of 10. So if I apply the common log to both sides, then the log base 10, which we don't have to write, and if it's not written, it is always implied to be 10. The log base 10 and the base 10 of the x will cancel out. The x falls down, and you get x equals log of 41. And just find that button on your calculator and get the appropriate decimal. Now here's one that takes a little bit more work. E to the 3x minus 4 equals 27... Minus 5 equals 27/16. Now we have our variable in the exponent, which means that we're going to require logarithms again to solve this equation, to get the variable down out of the exponent. You should not be attempting to apply the log to both sides of the equation until the term with the variable in the exponent is isolated. So before I try and get this x out of the exponent, I'm going to move the 5 over with addition and isolate that term with the variable in the exponent once again. So we're going to add 5 to both sides and get e to the 3x minus 4 equals 27/16 plus 5 is 27/21. Actually, I'm now noticing that my scratch work over there that I used to attempt to not make mistakes does have a sign error. So let me change that to plus 5 and change this then to 11 so I can check my decimal and give you an answer out of, you know, so you can see if you're using your calculator correctly. So let's make that plus 5 and subtract 5 from both sides. And that way again I can get it, I can just give you a decimal at the end so you're so you can check to see if you're using your calculator properly. Okay, we have a base of e, so I could use common log, but I'm going to use natural log to save a step, and I'm going to do the natural log of e to the 3x minus 4 equals the natural log of 27/11, and the log base e and the base e here are going to cancel out, giving us 3x minus 4 equals the natural log of 27/11. Now, I'm not going to put, well, you could put this in your calculator and get a decimal if you'd like to not write that much every single step, but remember when you're taking the log of a number, you are getting the exponent. So if you round off just a little bit too much, you can really throw off your final answer. So if you do want to make this a decimal, try rounding to the hundredths or the thousandths place. Usually rounding the logarithms off to the nearest tenths is too much rounding, okay? So I'm going to leave it here though, add 4 to both sides, and get 3x equals natural log of 27/11 plus 4, and then I'm going to divide everything by 3. Now, depending on your calculator, I like to put logs in all at once. Like this expression, I would just type in my calculator all at once and not have any round off error. And if you want to do that, just make sure because you have two terms in the top of this fraction that you wrap that in parentheses with your calculator. Unless, of course, you have a TI-84 with the updated software or the TI Inspire or some kind of calculator that you can type it in just like it looks on your, like it's called math type kind of idea where you can put it in your calculator and have it look just like it does in your textbook. If you can't, then it's probably going to look something like parentheses natural log parentheses of 2711, close those parentheses, plus 4, so you get that entire numerator with the two terms wrapped in parentheses, and then divide that by 3. If you get it typed in correctly, you're going to have a decimal of 2.64. So double check your use of your calculator, make sure you're getting those in properly. Okay, and that's why I wanted to change the sign there, because I realized my scratch work has a little sign error there. Okay, so you should be getting 2.64. All right, moving on. Next example, how about 5 to the x plus 4 equals 7, just to show you one where you don't just cancel out the base. No e, no 10, so it doesn't matter what log you use, you're still going to have to write pretty much just as much. We're going to take the natural log, because let's do natural log, I have to write less. Natural log of 5 to the x plus 4 equals natural log of 7. Again, we're doing this so that we can use the power properties of logarithms that will allow us to take that exponent off of the 5, which is where my variable is, and move it down in the main line of the problem. So we have x plus 4 times the natural log of 5 equals the natural log of 7. Now you can distribute this natural log or that decimal through the parentheses, but I'm going to show it where we just divide it away from the x and keep it more like I'm going to save myself a step, and I don't want to have this in decimal form and distribute it through the parentheses. So we're going to undo that multiplication with division and get x plus 4 equals the natural log of 7 divided by the natural log of 5. And now I've only got one step left, which is subtract both sides by 4, and I have my final answer for my equation. So x equals natural log of 7 divided by natural log of 5 minus 4. And if you would like to type that in your calculator and make sure the answer is right, I got negative 2.79. All right, bam! Moving on. Okay, this will probably be my last example before we start part 2. We're going to take a look at, make sure I have enough time to talk about this. No, I won't. So we'll start part 2 in just a second. We're going to start with this equation, e to the 4x plus e to the 2x minus 6 equals 0, and figure out what are we going to do to factor this very funny looking equation. I'm going to do it by comparing it to a normal standard quadratic equation and show you the comparisons so that you can more easily factor these problems for yourself. Bam!